Hey, Jorden Bench here, jordenbench.com, and this video is all about how to be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Now, if you're someone that wants to experience radical growth in your life, if you want to experience transformation, and you don't want to remain stagnant, you don't want to remain the same, then this video is for you. Now, when we talk about mind renewal, there's a whole lot of areas in which I can get into and talk about. But for the sake of this video, I'm just going to give you a good overview of what it is and how to do it. So I first need to start with the actual scripture in which this comes from, which is Romans 12:2. I have it right in front of me, so I'm going to read it to you. It says, "Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is the good and acceptable and perfect will of God." So if your mind is not renewed, you're not able to actually do that, right? Now, there's one thing that we need to look at with this verse, and it's don't be conformed to this world. So here's the problem. A lot of times when we grow up and we're influenced by certain people around us, we're influenced by television, the mind that we have is not according to what God has said about us or what he thinks about us, how he feels about us, and it's not the way that it's supposed to be, right? So we're supposed to have the mind of Christ. We're not supposed to have a mind that's been conformed to the world. So a big part of my renewal is actually getting the areas of unbelief out of our mind, the areas of unbelief towards God or towards the things of the things that are spiritual, things that are towards the Bible. We have to get those areas out, and we have to replace it with what God has said about us, with what he thinks, what he feels, basically getting it transformed to the mind of Christ, because that's the standard in which we're supposed to live to. So part of mind renewal is not what you may think. Because a lot of times what I've seen people think about mind renewal, they think that maybe if somebody prays over them, or if there's a word of prophecy given, or if they lay hands on them to receive something, or any other method, that's not mind renewal. That's not at all how it works. Mind renewal is simply getting your mind to line up to the Word of God, to where you're speaking and you're doing his actions of what he says about you and what we've been commanded to do. So your mind can only be renewed to the area in which you're able to walk it out in. So just simply reading scripture does not renew your mind, or memorizing Bible verse, that does not renew your mind. You have to be able to walk it out, because when you're able to walk it out and you're actually able to do it, that shows that your mind has been renewed to that area, to the degree in which you're able to actually do it. So there's one thing that we need to look at with mind renewal. So we're made up of three parts. So I'm made up of three parts, right? So I have a spirit. I'm sorry, I said that wrong. I am a spirit. I have a soul and I have a body. So when I got born again, what happened was my spirit, which was dead to God, was resurrected and it was recreated and it has been perfected. So my spirit is good, but I have a soul. My soul is my mind, my will, my emotions, my intellect, my thinking. That's your soul. Then you have a body, which this is this, right? This is my body. So I'm not my body. Like, I'm a spirit and I have a body. I'm a spirit and I have a soul. So the area that we need to work on is our soul. So like I said, that's your mind, your will, emotions, your intellect, your thinking, right? That's the area that we need to work on. So when it comes to renewing your mind, there's one area that I think really stands out above the rest on a fast way. Like, I would consider this one of the fastest ways to renew your mind, and it's simply immersion. So when I got saved, I actually had a lot of time to immerse myself into certain topics. So I would work at my 9-to-5 job. Well, actually it's like a 12-hour job, but I'd work at that job and I put headphones in. And the neat thing was they let us, you know, put headphones in and we could listen to stuff. So what I did was I listened to the Bible. I listened to sermons. I listened to various different courses. But what helped me out was when I could get specific and when I was listening to something. The more specific I could get and the longer I could listen to something on that kind of topic, the more and more I would dive into immersion and I would immerse myself into that topic. So when I first started doing was I just started listening to the Bible, because I had really not much understanding of the Bible. So I listened to the Bible. It took me about 5 weeks to go through the entire Bible, and I ended up doing that a couple times over. So I had a good overview picture of the Bible. But then what I started doing was I started diving into certain topics that I was interested in. One area was like healing. Another area was deliverance. Those are two different areas. So I began to just immerse myself into those topics. The more and more I immerse myself, the better understanding I had of it. Now, one thing that people do that kind of causes some problems is like they turn on Christian television. The problem with that, when they turn on Christian television is they're getting so many different types of shows that are non-related, and they cover so many different topics. So you never truly get like a good idea of the topic itself because you have all these other things going on and your mind can't focus on one particular area because it's so like scattered. So when you're actually able to go through a course, it is so beneficial because you're like doing a deep dive into that course and you're doing it for a long period of time. You're able to get a really good grasp on it. So a while back, I actually went through a course called Mind Renewal. It was by Curry Blake. And that course was so much in depth on how to renew your mind and dealing with the actual brain and how it all works with mind renewal and everything else. So by doing that, I think that course was like 18 hours long. And that's all I was listening to. That's all I was focused on, was just going through that course. And that's a big part of mind renewal, is when you're just immersing yourself into the topic. So hopefully I made myself clear with that. Another part of mind renewal is memorization, which is done by repetition, and the repetition leads to habit, and the habit actually leads to mind renewal, or you actually living the lifestyle and you actually doing it. So memorization is a big part of it, but here's the problem though. Simply knowing about something doesn't actually renew your mind. Like I can memorize Bible verses, I can memorize scripture, but if I'm not doing what the scripture says I'm supposed to do, then guess what? My mind has not been renewed to that topic. I am not actually doing it. There's a lot of people that memorize a lot of scriptures, but they don't actually believe it, or they don't actually understand it. If you don't understand it, then you're not actually able to have your mind renewed, because for your mind to be renewed to whatever topic, whatever the scriptures, whatever the verse is, you have to understand it. So it's so much better to have understanding than just to have simple memorization. Like I think of a parrot, you know, like a bird parrot, right? They can memorize Bible verses, but do you think they understand what the Bible verse actually is or what it means to them? No, not at all. They're just able to repeat something, right? So if you're able to memorize scripture and repeat something, but you don't understand it, that's a problem. You need to be able to understand what it is that you're memorizing, and then you apply it to your life and you begin to walk it out. All right, so here's another part of how you actually renew your mind. And I think this is like a big part of it. And a lot of it is controlling your mouth, controlling your speech. So what we need to do is, like, when you're in the Bible and you're reading, you're going through stuff, it's so important that the things that you're reading, you apply it to your life. But an area that you apply it is in your speech. So for instance, I'm not going to say things that go against what the Word of God says. I'm going to get my speech to line up to the Word of God about what God says, and I'm going to get my speech lining up to that. Because if I'm trying to renew my mind and my speech is saying something different, then that's a problem. Even with what I listen to, because like I think of like Christian worship music, all right? Now, for me, and I'm not putting this on you, but for me, what I do is I really analyze the lyrics and what I'm listening to. Because what I found is a lot of the Christian lyrics, they are Old Testament mindset, meaning that they don't actually step into the New Testament, the New Covenant, the New Creation. A lot of the songs actually deny what the New Creation is. So for me, I have to listen to songs and do lyric analysis, and I'm not going to sing songs or repeat songs that go against the New Creation of who I am. So like I said, your speech has a whole lot to do with it. Another way to renew your mind, and this is like one of the fastest ways, right? So for instance, you can sit in a lecture, you can sit in a seminar, you can hear someone talk about it, you can listen to audio, you can listen to all these different methods of how to renew your mind, or when you're listening to a certain topic. But each one of those things I just mentioned, they have a certain percentage of you actually retaining what you listen to, or what it is that you were trying to learn. Even if you were to read a book, there's a certain small percentage of you actually retaining that information. So what I'm saying is there's several different things that you can do that you're only going to have a very, very small percentage of retention when it comes to that topic. One of the best, highest level of retention, it's actually like 90% retention. So let's say you learn something, you read something, you listen to something. If you want to retain that, one of the fastest ways for you to retain that, one of the strongest ways, is for you to actually teach somebody else. Whether that's a class setting, whether that's just one-on-one, whether that's you making a video and then you speaking it out, whatever it is, you'll have 90% retention on doing that. So that right there is an easy way to renew your mind. You learn something and then you teach somebody else. Because the Bible says that we're to be, that we're to do and we're to teach. So that's a big part of it. When you teach, you're actually able to actually get it more solidified in you. And as you're teaching, the thing that you learn, guess what? More likely, because you're teaching it, you're going to actually step out and walk in it. So that right there is another big part of mind renewal. Acting it out in your life. Not just memorizing and not just reading, but actually teaching and then acting it out. So hopefully I gave you a good idea of what mind renewal is. I gave you a good like overview, a good idea of how mind renewal works and even like what mind renewal isn't. So if you like this video, please give this video a like, give it a thumbs up. Also, if you have any questions for me, please comment below and I'll be more than happy to talk with you and answer your questions. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel already, please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate any subscribers I get. I value each and every one of you. And hit that little bell so you get notified when I put a new video out. And I will see you in the next video.